Hello, everybody. I am Dude Harry. I'm here to introduce a film which you are about to view, about my adventures. And I think it's a very good film, detailing some of my greatest, some of the greatest adventures I've done. Either way, yeah, you wonder, who am I? Who is this Dude Harry? And you know, sometimes I wonder that too. Or maybe this, I'm eating my hair. Maybe this movie will give you something of a better idea of my character and who I am. So yeah, that's me, that's about me. I have two friends named Dude Bob and Dude Jack. They're younger than me, but they have helped me keep updated on the world and current events. So that sometimes I learn things. But another person in this movie who I might need to introduce you to is, his name is Austin Newton. He's very famous. He's a great adventurer. He's done many great things. He's saved the world from dinosaurs, from alien invasions, from political agents. He saved the iPhone from Russians. He's done other things. He's met many famous celebrities. He's great, and he's very, very rich. He's important in this movie, sort of, but not as important as me. So yeah, that's the intro to this movie. And without further ado, I would like you to observe this film, which is titled Dude Harry's Very Amazing Summer Vacation. Thank you very much. So it all began one morning on Austin Newton's farm.
What a beautiful morning. The sun is shining, the birds are singing. I'm even in a good mood. Good day for work on the farm. Almost never one loop. It's gonna be a good day. I'm not gonna lose my temper, okay? For this, no, I'm just not gonna lose my temper. It's gonna be a good day, okay? Don't worry, it's fine. I don't care that I almost broke my skull. Man, I really need to water these tomato plants. I need to weed these tomato plants. First, though, I will water them.
Still there?
Yes, you are still thoroughly intact.
Good to know.
It's good you don't have a hole in your head.
You know what?
What?
I need a vacation.
I thought you said you never wanted to leave.
That was this morning. Times have changed.
Someone will need to keep an eye on this place.
You're right.
What about Dude Harry? I like him.
What? Are you out of your mind? Well, yeah, you are, but...
I don't know. The vacation might be good for him, too.
I could give him a call. Where's the phone?
It's way over there, you doofus.
Oh.
You could get it with the force.
Yeah, I guess I could. I need training. Let's see. There it is. Let's see. Accounted for. Were you fighting a rhinoceros or something?
No, I was taking a nap, and I had a bit of an adventure here.
Oh, that figures.
So, bro, what are you up to? Maybe I should make some coffee here.
I'm just kind of relaxing.
Oh, dude, so am I. Relaxation, bros.
Well, I was about to ask you something, but I'm not sure I'm going to anymore.
Oh, come on, man. What's the question?
All right, yeah, I need a favor.
Oh! Bro, yeah, man. I can do whatever you want. Wait, is there servile labor involved?
I guess that depends on your perspective.
All right, well, shoot.
I've kind of realized that after receiving multiple injuries in battle, it would be best if I were to go on a vacation.
Oh man, I love vacating. Where do you think I'm going, Muskogee?
I don't know, I was kind of thinking tour the country or something.
And what do you need me to do?
Yeah, well, I was wondering if you can maybe keep an eye on my place for about a week.
Oh, it does not smell good in there. Do you have a built-in spa?
No, I definitely do not.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, do you have any, designated smoking locations?
Honestly, I'm really starting to have second thoughts about this.
Oh, don't worry. It would be totally legal.
Yes, I do not want the police coming to my place while I'm gone, okay?
Okay. I promise not to break anything or be illiterate or set off any fire alarms or anything. When do I need to come?
Yeah, if you could come out tomorrow and just check it out, yeah, I could show you around a little.
Oh, that would be rad.
Thank you.
No problem, bro.
You know, I want my house to still be here when I get back.
Dude, I get a free vacation!
Well, hello there.
Bro, what's up?
What happened to the Volkswagen?
Me and the government, we kind of had a falling out and they decided to confiscate it.
That would be you.
Well, that's enough about my disadventures. What do you need me to do?
You can feed the cats, take care of the birds, keep an eye on the dogs, make sure the horses don't escape.
Oh, that's not too much work.
Yeah, that's about it. Don't burn the place down. Iris said, I did not want the police involved. We don't need anything happening here. It can all just needs to be perfectly legal.
All right, I'll try. Where will you be?
I'm just going on a tour of the country. I'll be back in a week. Yeah, don't invite your friends.
Oh yeah, I understand. They can be a little wild sometimes. Young people.
Yeah, it'll be fun. Have a good time. Don't break anything too valuable.
No problem. Thank you. Bon voyage. All right, well, time to start house sitting, man. Oh, perfect. All set for summer vacation. I wonder if he has a TV.
Hello, this is Bill Forget It All from News for You. It's summer, and as fall is approaching, children across the United States have joined together in suing the United States, requesting that school be closed for the fall semester, and possibly for the spring as well. The Supreme Court may be taking up the case within the next few weeks. Hobbits have begun to move into New York City. They say that environmental problems are causing lots of rain in the Shire, and that the streams are freezing. There's something wrong here. Can I have another story? Thank you. A rogue Russian spy has been escaped from prison in the United States and is headed somewhere into Missouri. This Russian spy has been disavowed by the Kremlin, supposedly, though Putin has also been known to call her one of his most trusted allies, so we really don't know what's going on. But yes, this Russian spy is lost in the United States, or perhaps she's found where she is. I do not know what I'm saying. I'm sorry, this is a horrible news report. Goodbye. Yes, there's a Russian on the loose. Hobbits are moving into New York, and children are suing the United States.
Oh, dude, that is very interesting news. I'm hungry. Dude, I'm hungry. What should I... Oh, dude! What the heck? Dude! You're the chick from the Gremlin! The Gremlin, you know, the big onion thing in Moscow, where Putin hangs out.
You're disrespectful.
Wait, you were gonna, like, you're planning to start a nuclear war.
Well, originally I wanted to blow up the capital, but that was too much work, so I set up a nuclear war.
So, what are you gonna do with me?
Having hostages is nice, but I don't know if they would want you back.
Oh, dude, I've got lots of friends and... Well, I don't know if I have any family or not, but if I was a hostage, I would be very... Wait, why am I telling you this? No one wants me. There's really no point in having me. You should let me go free.
Why you have Christmas tree?
Well, I don't know, you know, Christmas in July and all that, even though I guess it's August, but, you know.
But you could be useful to me. You know, Arya.
Well, I mean, I've lived around here a while. I graduated from the college back in 86, or was that 66?
Probably like 45.
Oh, dude, that is very insulting.
I have number. Maybe you help me decode this?
N72S6R66. N72S6R66. I went to memorize
it
and eat it.
Finger.
Well, that's what you do in a spy movies. You memorize it and you eat it. That number, it sounds like a library number.
A library?
I bet it's like leading to a place in a library where, what in the world are you even looking for?
I'm not telling you.
Oh, come on. I can't help you if you don't help me.
Someone has hidden nuclear codes at that location. If you help me find them, maybe I'll not explode your head.
You are under arrest.
Oh, dude. Oh, is he dead? My brain's got the bends. Oh, man. I think it's too much water in the atmosphere.
We go to the library?
Wait, can I take this coffee?
No. That's mine.
And so we appropriated Austin Newton's minivan and headed to the college to try to find the location in the library. Now, I didn't want to betray my country or anything, but I certainly didn't want to die just yet.
Where is the library?
Dude, do you know how many years it's been since I was in college?
Money.
That was more of a rhetorical question. I think it's this way. You know, the other day, I was at a poetry reading, and there was this poem. It went like, "The owl and the pussycat went to sea. In a beautiful pea green boat, they took some honey, that's all I remember."
What does that have to do with anything?
Nothing, I'm just so scared right now, I might pass out.
If you pass out, I kill you.
Oh, that does not help me feel any less like passing out.
Well, this might distract you. It is a poem from our Russian
poem. Russian poem?
Yes. Cold.
Cold misery, vodka. I kind of like that poem. I think it's kind of nice.
Very good.
Let's see. Oh, dude, we're almost there. That's the library right there.
Okay, we will infiltrate.
Whoa, like Mission Impossible?
Yes, like Ted Cruz. We need to be very discreet.
Discreet, that's me. I'll blend right in. There's a door.
Very well, we
need to. Oh, a dungeon. Wow. Amazing. That's new. Where do we go now?
N72S6R66.
So we split up, and we start to look around the library for that number. I don't know what the spy was doing, but I was trying to delay. Because, you know, I didn't really want her to get away with the nuclear codes. They also had some good books. I didn't have a plan yet at this point, but I knew that she couldn't find them without me, but I was a super spy and very useful, so I just looked like I was looking. They honestly had some pretty cool artwork in the library. It had kind of been updated since I was last there. I knew the spy had to be getting closer, but I found a really cool picture of Thomas Jefferson on the wall. They had a big flag display in the library. That was new. And she went and saluted the flag of her country. I was watching. She was very patriotic. Speaking of which, so am I. She must have been closing in, and I couldn't stop her. Still, they had some really cool stools in the library. Dude, I don't know if I want to help blow up the whales.
Call him or I kill you.
That's a good enough reason. Alright, just a second here.
Alright, dudes. Welcome to my vlog. I'm Dude Jack. And today, we're going to be drinking Woodstain. Which is tastier? Harry? Hey, man.
Oh, sorry, man, but I'm in the middle of an international situation.
Oh, well, I'm drinking Woodstain. What do you need?
Yeah, well, I need to hack into the government.
Oh, well, that's easy, man. So, do you have a computer? Can you read me the number?
Can you read the number on the computer?
7350.
7350. And the three-letter code afterwards.
639.
639.
That's numbers, not letters.
That's three numbers, the three letters.
B-A-L.
B-A-L.
So, man, what are you doing?
Well, we're starting a nuclear war. Well, we're trying to, help baby children.
Dude, what's the statute of limitations for starting a nuclear war?
I don't know, ask Siri.
Well, it can't be that bad.
Okay.
Alright, let me see here. Alright, you should be in.
Alright, you should be good.
You have the codes.
Good. Alright, bye. Thanks. We'll see you in the afterlife.
Bye, man. All right, welcome back. Ignore that part of this vlog. So, which is tasty?
Now we go to Mrs.
Side.
Sweet heavens, hold on.
Drink it?
Inject it.
Inject it? Oh, dude. What's it do?
Okay.
My stars, what was that?
I'm still headed. Like, not beheaded. Oh no, it's you.
You! You're one of the criminals. You're under arrest.
Wait a second. No, I'm not a criminal. Well, actually, I probably am, but not the kind you think.
You've been colluding with that Russian.
Dude, I haven't been polluting anything. No, I'm as green as grass, like, when it's not dry outside.
Then why were you in the company of that notorious Russian spy?
But believe me, it's not because I think it's hip. It's because she said she'd end my being if I didn't go along.
Go along with what?
Her evil plans, of course.
What were those plans?
Well, she was gonna blow up the Capitol, but she decided that was too much work. So she decided to start a nuclear war.
A what kind of war?
A nuclear war. Like, bad times. But I was tagging along to foil her evil plans. Like, you know, to not go along with her plans. To be a not, to not die. But yeah, to foil her evil designs.
Well, I thought you might have been an old hippie wanting revenge for the 1980s.
I mean, I would not destroy Mother Earth, even for that.
Where was she going next? What are you doing lying on the ground here?
To be fair, I have no idea how I got here.
Where's the spy?
Oh, dude, I remember she got the coats, and she's going to the missile saloon.
Missile saloon?
Yeah, no idea what that is.
You mean missile silo?
That sounds better.
I didn't know we had any missile silos around here. I have to call the Pentagon. Shoot, I really ought to label my contacts. Hello? Connecting to strategic defense. Mom, I thought you were the Pentagon. No, I don't think you're fat. Now my mom's mad at me. Let's see if this is it.
Hey.
Hello. Do we have any silos near my location?
What, like, grain silos?
Silos. Missile silos.
No, bro, but I think, like, I have some Drano around here. You wanna buy some?
We're on the verge of the apocalypse, and you're trying to sell me Drano! Maybe this is the number. Let's start walking to my car.
I hope you get a hold of the pentagram soon, because I did not want to explode.
Hello. Is this strategic defense? Yes. Are there any missile silos near my location? Share my location? I don't know how to share my location. What do you think I am, a teenager? There, is that better? 2 miles away. Holy baloney, they put those things everywhere. Next you'll be finding them in grandma's apple pie. All right. Thank you. Goodbye. Love you.
What?
First I tell my mom she looks like the Pentagon, and then I tell a nuclear technician I love him. It's a bad day.
Uh-oh. It just got worse, man.
What do you mean?
Somebody slashed your tires.
Gosh golly, shoot, that is not cool. We have to run. Come on, follow me.
Dude, I have not run this much in one day since they were trying to draft me.
What did you say?
Nothing.
Thank you.
This is it. Come on.
Wait, it's locked.
Oh, good gravy.
I'm in. Oh, dude, I am so sorry. Oh, man, I guess I'm on my own. I'm like the Lone Ranger. Except more alone because he has Tonto. Oh, dear, which way? Oh, man. Oh, dude. Oh, dude, I feel like the president. Okay, here goes.
There you are.
It's you.
30 seconds. It's optimal team.
It's the codes.
This missile silo was shut down 35 years ago. There's nothing in here.
Oh, dude. What the heck? All this for nothing?
And that's a theater light.
Something seems wrong.
All right, it's time to go.
Are you sending me back to Russia or prison? Please send me to prison.
I don't know, but I'm sure they're going to have a beef with you in Washington.
Oh, dude, yeah. I don't want her anymore.
All right.
What about me? I might kind of be a bit incriminated in all of these goings on.
Well, you tried, unsuccessfully, to help me. And you tried to help me, but you knocked me out with the door. But at least you didn't seem that vicious, and I think you like peace. So I think they'll let you off the hook for now.
Well, that's relieving. Thank you very much.
Yeah, but you better get out of here.
I will. I definitely will. I do not want to stay in this dilapidated, empty, boring missile silo any longer. So about a week later, I was just sitting there playing Austin's guitar and harmonica when something very surprising happened.
Oh, how many times
have I... Oh, dude, I'm going to jail for sure.
Not exactly. Someone is here to see you.
Oh no, my mom. That's even worse.
No. I would like to present the President of the United States.
Oh, dude!
Mr. President? He's this way.
Hello, I'm Bo Jiden.
Mr. President, you haven't quite made it yet.
Oh. How's your butter, huh?
Mr. President, to what do I owe this most obscene honor?
Oh, let me take off these glasses. Oh, where's my speech?
Oh, here it is.
Oh, thank you. Не ладит, это все, все ищип, это не собрачивание.
Ahem, Mr. President. Mr. President, the speech is upside down.
Oh, I thought it was Romanian. Dude, Harry, in recognition of your assistance in opposing the enemies of this nation, what nation is this? The President of the United States, Bill Clinton, would like to award you.
Ahem.
Ahem yourself, would like to award the medal of this space left blank for particular medal. Of excellence in confusing situations. And confusing the enemies of the United States, you would preserve the liberties of the free world, whatever those may be. You slowed the progress of the enemy, probably unintentionally, and you extrapolated the flame of freedom in the hearts of your fellow Americans. Tomorrow may come, but today is forever. In the hearts of your countrymen, of your enemies, and of your friends.
What does this even mean?
Nobody knows. The Vice President wrote it. You are a true patriot, but first and foremost, you are a dude. Therefore, I present you with this medal as a token of my page 2. Underline gratitude and admiration. Wear it with honor and latitude. Your smell may rise to the heavens, but your eyes are in the top of our souls.
Cut the speech short. It's getting bad. Oh, you froze up. Watch.
Oh, where are my teeth?
In your head, sir.
Oh, I knew I lost them somewhere. Oh, yeah. Here's your medal. That's a rock.
Well, we knew you were a hippie, so we thought this might be more environmentally friendly.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate your considerality. Wear it with pride. Bye. God save Queen Charles.
Bye. It's his nap time.
Well, don't worry, it's mine too.
What in the world was that?
Oh my goodness, you're home. I wanted to say thank you very much for watching this movie. I think it hopefully moved you deeply and taught you, gave you new perspective on humanity and the world, and also a greater understanding of me and who I am. Also, the whales need you. Every day, millions of whale eggs are destroyed by capitalism. If you donate $1, you can save one whale egg. And that whale egg will hatch and become a tadpole and eventually will grow into one of the majestic creatures which we know as whales. I would also like to encourage you to donate to my my legal defense. So please vote for me. Give me money, please. And it will go to a good cause. Thank you for watching this film. I hope you have been entertained and uplifted. I hope it's helped you find some of your zen. If you're looking for that. Thanks, and peace out.